Hello everyone, welcome to this tutorial on using DMX channels to control parameters in the DMX to PangoScript settings in Pangolin BEYOND. In this video, we're going to go over the basic idea of how to use and set up custom DMX controls. This method of control is a great alternative to MIDI controllers and allows more freedom of control while operating lighting and lasers in a freeform environment by simplifying control to a single control surface and still allowing both systems to be driven independently. This setup does count toward the 4-in and 4-out DMX subsystem, and unlike the DMX server, this uses ARTnet or an in-tech USB DMX adapter for DMX input and output. For this tutorial, I will use an ARTnet universe for DMX input. Go to Settings, DMX, DMX ARTnet Settings, choose an input, and assign a universe to it. Click OK through the menus. To control a parameter of an effect with a DMX channel, first select the effect you wish to control. Then click Input. Select the DMX channel and choose a channel. Assign a minimum and maximum value you'd like that parameter to output, then click OK. Run a cue and the effect. On the lighting desk, operate the channel you assigned to the effect parameter. There are more than 70 key effects ready to be controlled using parameters. Parameters can be used to control functions other than effects. Oscillators and modulators can be linked to DMX values. That allows us to use DMX as a source of abstract imagery in the LD2000 Abstract Generator. To assign DMX values in the LD2000 Abstract Generator, in an empty queue, right-click, Create, New LD2000 Abstract Generator. Click on the input button assigned to the parameter you want to control, and assign a DMX channel to it. Click OK and run the queue. As you affect those channels, the changes are shown in the abstract being played back. Next is the DMX Image Generator. The DMX Image Generator allows us to transform DMX data into a sequence of XY coordinates and RGB colors. You can configure DMX to control any combination of the XY RGB values. This is a way for lighting operators to take a challenge and get direct control of lasers down to points. In the editor, the first parameter we can assign a DMX channel to is points. This option is the basis for everything we can design with this editor. It will dictate how many DMX channels you will actually be using to control the points. Each point will be assigned its own X and Y coordinate value to be controlled by DMX. You can enable these coordinates to operate with 16-bit coordinates as well. Be very careful with the number of point values, as this can increase your DMX channel requirement to over 512. Next, we can assign color. This is a universal value, meaning all points will be using the assigned color. You can assign the RGB values to DMX channels. Below our color section, we have our coordinate section. In this section, we can assign a DMX channel to the points beginning with the first X point value through the last X point value. I've already created a sequence on my lighting controller to provide an example of how the image works. To control DMX to PangoScript functions, go to Settings, DMX, and choose DMX to PangoScript. In here, we are given a channel address list of 512 parameters for each DMX input available in BEYOND to assign our own PangoScripts to. Let's start with channel 1. In here, I will assign a function to control brightness. You can assign this to be zone-specific or master control. For this tutorial, I'll assign to master brightness. Click OK. On channel 2, I will assign a function that will toggle through the active page, and on channel 3, I will assign a function that will play a cue on the active page. For the sake of time, I'll load up a script I have already created. Displayed on the screen is a script for channel 2, and displayed is the script for channel 3. For the page and cue scripts to work properly, I will need to set up and initialize the variables used to identify my page and cue choices. This is done in the background script section by adding a script with a few simple lines. This can also be set up in the right tab PangoScript section as well. On my lighting desk, I'll bring the brightness to full and start triggering cues. These are just a few examples of the infinite possible combinations of controls and parameters that can be assigned to DMX channels and values. To set up DMX output, go to Settings, DMX, DMX ArtNet Settings. Choose an output and assign it to a universe. For this tutorial, I will use ArtNet and Universe 1. Click the Quick DMX tab below and click Show It Now. Go ahead and change values of the DMX channels you assigned PangoScripts to. Click the plus sign to add another step and change channel values. Click play to watch the DMX sequence play. Not only can you sequence DMX lighting with the DMX channels, but you can also sequence parameters and beyond. To save your sequence, just drag and drop the channel value window to an empty queue. To physically output DMX to lighting, you'll need an Intech USB DMX adapter or an ArtNet to DMX 512 converter. Should you have any questions, don't hesitate to email them to us, and be sure to like and subscribe for more tutorials. Thanks for watching!